Warming up. Chit chat. A lie can run round the world before truth has got its boots on. The above quotation expresses how fast rumors spread. Talk with your group about some recent rumor when people believed at first and suffered for it later. Answer. There was a rumor recently in my locality about a travel company that it was promising people a world tour at just Rs. 50,000. It had begun from a man's misinterpretation of a newspaper ad which stated that the company was offering a discount of Rs. 50,000. In no time, people were ready to book the tour for themselves. They started contacting the company in a rush so that they don't miss the wonderful opportunity. On hearing the rumor, a con man had an idea. He claimed to be an employee of the company and started taking money from people as advance. He presented a fake ID card of himself, made fake bookings for the people, and even gave them a fake receipt for the payment that they made. He took as many bookings as he could in a week and asked people to visit the company's office in a week's time to discuss further details. After a week, when people started showing up at the company's office, they found out that the man never worked there and that the whole thing was a scam. More than 15 families were the victims of this scam and vowed never to believe in any such rumor again. Also discuss how one can decide whether some news is a fact or fake. Answer. The first thing that people should do when they hear any news is verify the source of that news. They should ensure that the news is coming from a trusted source. People often make the mistake of trusting what they hear. If the news is about someone witnessing something unusual or out of the ordinary, then people should go and witness it themselves before believing it to be true. It is important to check all the facts about a situation, check the likelihood of the occurrences of that specific news, and then come to a conclusion based on the information that they gather. Only then can one decide whether a piece of news is fact or fake. Who do you think are responsible for spreading false news? Answer. There are many kinds of people who are responsible for spreading fake news. People who don't think before they speak generally spread a lot of fake news. There are also people who love to gossip and therefore spread rumors, so as to fuel more gossip. Some people spread fake news just for fun, so that they can create problems for others. All these kinds of people are responsible for spreading fake news. Do you believe in all the news that you come across? Answer. No, I do not believe in all the news that I come across. That is because I think it is important to find out for myself if something is true or not. I understand that there are people among us who like to spread rumors and not everything that they say is true. I think, as individuals, it is our responsibility to check the truth about a news story before believing it. Give one example of a rumor which seemed to be a fact in the beginning, later it was proved false. Answer. Last year, there was a rumor about a monkey man doing the rounds. It was believed that an ape with sharp teeth and pointed claws was breaking into people's houses at night and attacking them. But no one was ever able to see his face clearly. The rumor was so widespread that people started staying up at night with weapons in their hands to protect themselves. No one dared to step out at night for the fear of being attacked. The panic of Monkey Man's attack stayed for a few weeks before people realized that it was nothing but a rumor. Some kids had spread the fake news of the Monkey Man just to have some fun. 2. Read the following statements. Describe whether it is fact or rumor. Justify your decision. Answer. Number. Statements. Fact. Rumor. Explanation. 1. Cow gives birth to a calf. Fact. Explanation. A cow is a viviparous mammal that gives birth directly to its young one, the calf. 2. In 2025, the sun will swallow the earth. Rumor. There is no scientific evidence to back up the statement. 3. You receive a message that you have won rupees 5 crore in a lottery. Rumor: one cannot win a lottery without buying a ticket. Also, there are many scams where people are duped by such messages. 4. Bees beat their wings 270 times in a second. Rumor: bees beat their wings 230 times in a second. 5. Many ships and aeroplanes have disappeared in the Bermuda Triangle. Fact: the disappearances are being recorded since the last century. 6. Driverless cars are no more a dream. Fact: driverless cars have already been made and are being tested across the globe. 7. Sophia is the world's first robot citizen. Fact: Sophia was developed by Hanson Robotics in Hong Kong and activated in the year 2015. 8. Ghosts dwell in banyan trees. Rumor: there is no substantial evidence to support the statement. 9. Do not step out on a new moon day. Rumor: it is just a popular folklore that has no basis to back it up. 10. Aliens will conquer the earth. Rumor: there is no scientific evidence to back up the statement. The boy who broke the bank.
Bankela divalkhor banavnara mulga.
Ruskin Bond, 1934, is an Indian author of British descent. He lives with his adopted family in Landour in Mussoorie, India. The Indian Council for Child Education has recognized his role in the growth of children's literature in India. He got the Sahitya Academy Award in 1992 for Our Trees Still Grow in Dehra. He was awarded Padma Shri and Padma Bhushan respectively in 1999 and 2014. Descent means Parshwabhumi.
Ruskin Bond, 1934. हे ब्रिटिश वंशाचे एक भारतीय लेखक आहेत. भारतातील मसुरीमधील लँडॉर या ठिकाणी ते आपल्या दत्तक परिवारासह राहतात. भारतातील लहान मुलांच्या साहित्याच्या विकासासाठी मुलांच्या शिक्षणासाठी असलेल्या भारतीय परिषदेने त्यांची यातील भूमिका ओळखली आहे. ऑफ ट्रीज स्टील ग्रो इन देहरा यासाठी त्यांना 1992 साली साहित्य अकादमीचा पुरस्कार मिळाला होता. 1999-2014 मध्ये त्यांना अनुक्रमे पद्मश्री आणि पद्मभूषण या पुरस्कारांनी सन्मानित करण्यात आले होते.
Nathu grumbled to himself as he swept the steps of the People Nagar Bank owned by Seth Govindram. He used the small broom hurriedly and carelessly, and the dust, after rising in a cloud above his head, settled down again on the steps. Grumbled means
swatahashis badbadat.
Hurriedly means manje patafat, ghaine.
Sheth Govindaram यांच्या मालकीच्या असलेल्या पीपल नगर बँकेच्या पायऱ्या साफ करत असताना नथू स्वतःशीच बडबडत होता. घाई घाईने आणि निष्काळजीपणे त्याने लहान झाडू घेतल्याने सगळी धूळ त्याच्या डोक्यावरून उडून पुन्हा पायऱ्यांवरच पसरली.
As Nathu was banging his pan against a dustbin, Sitaram, the washerman's son, passed by. Sitaram was on his delivery round. He had a bundle of freshly pressed clothes balanced on his head.
Nathu साफ केलेले भांडे कचऱ्याच्या डब्यावर आपटत असताना साफ सफाई करणाऱ्या धोबी सीतारामचा मुलगा तिथून गेला. सीताराम रोजचे धुवून इस्त्री केलेले कपडे घरी पोहोचवण्यासाठी आला होता. तो त्याच्या डोक्यावर इस्त्री केलेल्या कपड्यांच्या गाठोड्याचा तोल सांभाळत येत होता.
Don't raise such dust, he called out to Nathu. Are you annoyed because they are still refusing to pay you an extra 2 rupees a month? I don't wish to talk about it, complained the sweeper boy. I haven't even received my regular pay. And this is the 20th of the month. Annoyed means angry, manje chidlela.
Ashi dhool udavu nakos, to Nathuvar oradlaj. त्यांनी महिन्याला 2 रुपये वाढवून दिले नाही म्हणून तू त्यांच्यावर अजून चिडलेला आहेस का? मला त्याबद्दल काही बोलायचे नाही, झाडू मारणाऱ्या मुलाने दुःख व्यक्त केले. मला माझा या महिन्याचा पगारही मिळालेला नाही आणि आजचा महिन्याचा 20वा दिवस आहे.
Who would think a bank would hold up a poor man's salary? As soon as I get my money, I am off. Not another week I work in this place. And Natho banged the pan against the dustbin several times just to emphasize his point and give himself confidence. Emphasize means लक्ष वेधणे.
एखाद्या गरीब माणसाचा पगार थांबून ठेवणारे हे बँकवाले काय समजतात? माझे पैसे जेव्हा मला मिळतील मी येथून निघून जाणार आहे. अजून एकही जास्त आठवडा मी या जागेवर काम करणार नाही. आणि नथू त्याचा मुद्दा ठासून सांगण्यासाठी आणि स्वतःला विश्वास देण्यासाठी कचऱ्याच्या डब्यावर भांडं आपटत होता.
वेल, आय विश यू लक, सेड सीताराम. I'll keep a lookout for any jobs that might suit you. And he plodded barefoot along the road, the big bundle of clothes hiding most of his head and shoulders. Plodded means pai aptat. Barefoot, Anwani.
ठीक है, मी तुला शुभेच्छा देतो, सीताराम म्हणाला. मी तुला योग्य असेल अशी एखादी नोकरी शोधण्याचा प्रयत्न करेन. आणि तो तसाच अनवाणीच रखडत बाहेर चालत गेला. त्याच्या डोक्यावरच्या कपड्यांच्या मोठ्या गाठोड्याने जवळजवळ त्याचे डोके आणि खांदे लपवले होते.
At the fourth home he visited, Sitaram heard the lady of the house mention that she was in need of a sweeper. Tying his bundle together, he said, I know of a sweeper boy who's looking for work. He can start from next month. He is with the bank just now. But they aren't giving him his pay and he wants to leave.
चौथ्या घरात पोहोचल्यावर सीतारामने एका बाईला उल्लेख करताना ऐकले की तिला झाडू मारणाऱ्याची गरज आहे. त्याचे गाठोडे पुन्हा एकत्र बांधून तो म्हणाला, मी एक कचरा काढणाऱ्याच्या मुलाला ओळखतो जो काम शोधत आहे. तो पुढल्या महिन्यापासून कामाला येऊ शकतो. आता सध्या तो एका बँकेत काम करतोय पण ते त्याला त्याचा पगार देत नाहीत म्हणून त्याला ती नोकरी सोडायची आहे.
Is that so? said Mrs. Srivastava. Well, tell him to come and see me tomorrow. And Sitaram, glad that he had been of service to both a customer and his friend, hoisted his bag on his shoulders and went his way. Hoisted means वर उचलली.
हो का? सौ श्रीवास्तव म्हणाले, ठीक आहे, त्याला उद्या मला येऊन भेटायला सांग. आणि आपले गाठोडे खांद्यावर उचलून घेऊन आपल्या मित्राच्या आणि आपल्या ग्राहकाच्या तो उपयोगी पडला ह्यामुळे सीताराम खूप खुश झाला आणि तो तेथून निघाला.
मिसेस श्रीवास्तवा हॅड टू डू सम शॉपिंग. शी गेव इन्स्ट्रक्शन टू दी आया अबाउट लुकिंग आफ्टर द बेबी अँड टोल्ड द कुक नॉट टू बी लेट विथ द मिड डे मील. Then she set out for the People Nagar marketplace to make her customary tour of the clothes shops. Customary means nehmi pramane.
सौ श्रीवास्तवना शॉपिंग करण्यासाठी जायचं होतं. त्यांनी बाळावर लक्ष ठेवण्यास आयाला सांगितलं आणि दुपारचे जेवण बनवण्यास उशीर करू नये अशी सूचना तिला दिली. नंतर त्यांनी पिंपळ नगरच्या बाजारात सवयीप्रमाणे कपड्यांच्या दुकानात फेरफटका मारला.
A large shady tamarind tree grew at one end of the bazaar, and it was here that Mrs. Srivastav found her friend Mrs. Bhushan sheltering from the heat. Sheltering means asra.
बाजाराच्या एका टोकाशी चिंचेचे मोठ्या आकाराचे झाड होते आणि त्या झाडाखाली सावलीत उभे असलेल्या सौ भूषण या सौ श्रीवास्तव यांची मैत्रीण त्यांना भेटली.
Mrs. Bhushan was fanning herself with a large handkerchief. She complained of the summer, which she affirmed was definitely the hottest in the history of People Nagar. Fanning means हवेसाठी कशाने तरी वारा घालणे. Affirmed means जाहीर करणे.
सौ भूषण स्वतःला हात रुमालाने वारा घालत होत्या. पिंपळ नगरच्या इतिहासातील सर्वात गरम दिवस असल्याचे ठामपणे सांगत खूप जास्त उन्हाळा असल्याची तक्रार त्या करत होत्या.
शी देन शोड मिसेस श्रीवास्तवा अ सॅम्पल ऑफ द क्लॉथ शी वॉज गोइंग टू बाय अँड फॉर 5 मिनिट्स दे डिस्कस्ड इट्स शेड टेक्स्चर अँड डिझाईन.
त्यांनी श्रीवास्तवबाईंना घेतलेले कापड दाखवले आणि पुढची 5 मिनिटे त्या कापडाचा रंग पोत आणि डिझाईन बद्दल चर्चा करत होत्या.
Having exhausted this topic, Mrs. Srivastava said, "Do you know, my dear, that Seth Govindram's bank can't even pay its employees? Only this morning, I heard a complaint from their sweeper who hasn't received his wages for over a month."
त्या विषयाचा कंटाळा येऊन श्रीवास्तवबाई म्हणाल्या, तुम्हाला माहित आहे का की शेठ गोविंदराम यांची बँक त्यांच्या कर्मचाऱ्यांना त्यांचा पगार देत नाही? आज सकाळीच मी त्यांच्या कचरेवाल्याकडून तक्रार ऐकली की बँकवाल्यांनी त्याला त्याचा या महिन्याचा पगार दिलेला नाही.
शॉकिंग, रिमार्क मिसेस भूषण. इफ दे कांट पे द स्वीपर, दे मस्ट बी इन अ बॅड वे. नन ऑफ द अदर्स कुड बी गेटिंग पेड ईदर.
खूपच धक्कादायक आहे, सौ भूषण यांनी अशी टिप्पणी केली. जर ते कचरेवाल्याला पगार देऊ शकत नसतील तर त्यांची परिस्थिती खराब असली पाहिजे.
She left Mrs. Srivastava at the tamarind tree and went in search of her husband, who was sitting in front of Kamal Kishore's photography shop, talking with the owner. "So there you are," cried Mrs. Bhushan. "I've been looking for you for almost an hour. Where did you disappear?"
बाकीच्यांना ही पगार मिळतो की नाही कोणास ठाऊ. भूषण बाईंनी श्रीवास्तव बाईंचा चिंचेच्या झाडाशी निरोप घेतला आणि त्या आपल्या नवऱ्याला, जो एका फोटोग्राफरच्या दुकानाच्या मालकाशी बोलत होता, तेथे शोधण्यासाठी निघून गेल्या. तुम्ही इथे आहात तर, भूषणबाई जवळजवळ रडतच म्हणाल्या, मी 1 तासापासून तुम्हाला शोधत होते, तुम्ही कुठे हरवला होतात?
Nowhere, replied Mr. Bhushan. Had you remained stationary in one shop, I might have found you. But you go from one shop to another like a bee in a flower garden. Stationary means स्थिर.
कुठे नाही, श्री भूषण उत्तरले. तू एकाच दुकानात थांबली असतीस तर मी तुला शोधू शकलो असतो, पण तू फुलबाग येथील मधमाशी सारखी एका दुकानातून दुसऱ्या दुकानात हिंडत होतीस.
डोंट स्टार्ट ग्रम्बलिंग, द हीट इज ट्राइंग इनफ. आय डोंट नो व्हॉट्स हॅपनिंग टू पीपल नगर. इवन द बँक्स अबाउट टू गो बँकक्राफ्ट. ग्रम्बलिंग म्हणजे चिडचिडणे. बँकक्राफ्ट मीन्स दिवाळखोरी.
आता कुरकूर नको, तसेही खूप गर्मी आहे. समजत नाही पिंपळ नगरला काय झालंय, अगदी बँकही कर्जबाजारी होत चालली.
व्हॉट्स दॅट, सेट कमल किशोर सिटिंग अप सडनली. विच बँक? वाय, द पिंपळ नगर बँक ऑफकोर्स. आय हिअर दे हॅव स्टॉप पेईंग एम्प्लॉईज. डोंट टेल मी यू हॅव अन अकाउंट देअर, मिस्टर किशोर.
काय ते, कोणती बँक? कमल किशोर यांनी अचानक उठत विचारले. अर्थातच पिंपळ नगर बँक. मी असं ऐकलंय की त्यांनी त्यांच्या कर्मचाऱ्यांना पगार देणं थांबवलं आहे. तुमचं तेथे खातं तर नाही ना किशोर साहेब?
नो, बट माय नेबर हॅज, ही एक्सक्लेम्ड अँड ही कॉल्ड आउट ओव्हर द लो पार्टिशन टू द कीपर ऑफ द बार्बर शॉप नेक्स्ट डोर. दीपचंद, हॅव यू हर्ड द लेटेस्ट? द पिंपळ नगर बँक इज अबाउट टू कोलॅप्स. यू'ड बेटर गेट युअर मनी आउट एज सून एज यू कॅन. एक्सक्लेम्ड मीन्स उद्गारणे.
नाही, पण माझ्या शेजाऱ्याचे आहे, ते उद्गारले. आणि पुढच्या नाव्याच्या दुकानाची विभाजक भिंत खाली असल्याने दुकानदाराला मोठ्याने हाक मारली. दीपचंद, तुम्ही ताजी बातमी ऐकलीत का? पिंपळ नगर बँक कोसळण्याच्या मार्गावर आहे. लवकरात लवकर बँकेत असलेले पैसे काढून घ्या.
दीपचंद, हु वॉज कटिंग द हेअर ऑफ एन एल्डरली जेंटलमॅन, वॉज सो स्टार्टल्ड दॅट हिज हँड शुक and he nicked his customer's right ear. The customer yelped with pain and distress. Pain because of the cut and distress because of the awful news he had just heard. Startled means dhakka basla. Nicked, choti cheer padli.
Deepchand eka vayaskar manasache kes kapat hote. Achanak he aiklyane aashcharyane dachkun tya manasacha ujvya kanajavar kaple gele. गिराईक दुःखाने आणि वेदनेने एकदम किंचाळलाच दुःखाने यासाठी की त्याला कापले म्हणून आणि यातना यासाठी की त्याने ऐकलेल्या भयंकर बातमीमुळे.
With one side of his neck still unshaven, he sped across the road to the general merchant store where there was a telephone. He dialed Seth Govindram's number. The Seth was not at home. Where was he then? The Seth was holidaying in Kashmir. Oh, was that so? Sped means vegane padala.
Tachi ekka bajula ajun dadhi hi shillak rahili hoti. Tarihi rastyacha dusrya bajula तिथे किराणा मालाच्या दुकानात फोन होता. तिथे तो वेगाने पळाला. त्याने शेठ गोविंदराम यांचा नंबर फिरवला. शेठ बहुतेक घरात नव्हते. मग कुठे होते ते? शेठजी काश्मीर मध्ये सुट्टीचा आनंद घेत होते. ओहो, असे आहे तर.
The elderly gentleman did not believe it. He hurried back to the barber's shop and told Deepchand. The bird has flown. Seth Govindram has left town. Definitely, it means a collapse. And then he dashed out of the shop, making a beeline for his office and checkbook. Beeline, ekdam thet saral.
त्या वयस्कर गृहस्थांना यावर विश्वासच बसला नाही. परत वेगाने ते न्हाव्याच्या दुकानात आले आणि दीपचंदला म्हणाले, पक्षी तर उडून गेला, शेठ गोविंदराम तर कधीच शहर सोडून निघून गेले. नक्कीच याचा अर्थ आहे बँकेचे दिवाळे वाजले आहे. आणि ते दुकानाच्या बाहेर पडले आणि थेट ऑफिस आणि चेकबुकच्या दिशेने सरळ गेले.
The news spread through the bazaar with the rapidity of forest fire. From the general merchants, it traveled to the shop, circulated amongst the customers, and then spread with them in various directions to the beetle seller, the tailor, the free vendor, the jeweler, the beggar sitting on the pavement. बीटल सेलर पानवाला.
ही बातमी पूर्ण बाजारात वणव्यासारखी पसरली. किराणा मालाच्या दुकानापासून ते न्हाव्याचे दुकान, सर्व ग्राहकांपर्यंत. आणि त्यांच्यामुळे ही बातमी पानपट्टीवाला, शिंपी, रस्त्यावरील विक्रेते, सोनार, फुटपाथवर बसलेले भिकारी अशा वेगवेगळ्या लोकांपर्यंत पसरत गेली.
ओल्ड गणपत द बेगर हॅड अ क्रूकेड लेग. He had been squatting on the pavement for years, calling for alms. In the evening, someone would come with a barrow and take him away. Crooked, vakra. Squatting, thaan mandun basla. Aims, bheek. Barrow, hatgadi.
Garib mhatara bhikari Ganpat sa pai vakda hota. To kittek varshan pasun phutpathvar ukidve basun bheek magat ase. संध्याकाळी कोणीतरी दोन चाकी हातगाडी घेऊन येत असे व त्याला घेऊन जात असे.
He had never been known to walk, but now, on learning that the bank was about to collapse, Ganpat astonished everyone, leaping to his feet and actually running at top speed in the direction of the bank. It soon became known that he had 1,000 rupees in savings. Astonished, आश्चर्यचकित. Leaping, उड्या मारत झेप घेत.
त्याला चालणे हे माहीतच नव्हते, पण बँकेचे दिवाळे वाजले आहे हे ऐकून गणपत आपल्या पायाने उडी मारून बँकेच्या दिशेने जोरात धावत जाऊन त्याने सगळ्यांना आश्चर्यचकित केले होते. यामुळे सगळ्यांना कळले होते की त्याची 1,000 रुपयांची शिल्लक त्या बँकेत होती.
Men stood in groups at street corners discussing the situation. People Nagar seldom had a crisis. Seldom or never had floods, earthquakes or drought. And the imminent crash of the People Nagar Bank set everyone talking and speculating and rushing about in a frenzy. Drought, Dushkar. Imminent, Sankat. Speculating, Afwa. Frenzy, Vedya Sarkhe.
रस्त्याच्या कडेला उभे राहून माणसे एकमेकांशी या संदर्भात बोलत होते. पिंपळ नगर मध्ये क्वचितच काहीतरी संकट आलं होतं. क्वचित काय, पण कधीही पूर, भूकंप अथवा दुष्काळही आला नव्हता. आणि पिंपळ नगर बँकेच्या जवळ येऊन उभ्या राहिलेल्या संकटामुळे सगळेच जण त्याबद्दल चर्चा आणि तर्कवितर्क करत वेड्यासारखे पळापळ करत होते.
Some boasted of their far-sightedness, congratulating themselves on having already taken out their money or on never having put any in. Others speculated on the reasons for the crash, putting it all down to excesses indulged in by Seth Govindram. Boast, dekhava kela. Farsightedness, durdrushti. Crash, padun modne. Excess, atirikta. Indulged in, maja ghene.
काही जण त्यांच्या दूरदृष्टीबद्दल बढाया मारत होते. आधीच पैसे काढून घेण्याच्या हुशारीबद्दल किंवा कधीच बँकेत पैसे न ठेवल्याबद्दल स्वतःलाच शुभेच्छा देत होते. इतर काही जण शेठ गोविंदराम यांचे आवश्यकतेपेक्षा जास्त लाड पुरवल्यामुळे बँक कर्जबाजारी झाली असावी असा तर्क करत होते.
The Seth had fled the state, said one. He had fled the country, said another. He was hiding in People Nagar, said a third. He had hanged himself from the tamarind tree, said a fourth, and had been found that morning by the sweeper boy.
एक म्हणाला, शेठजी तर राज्याच्या बाहेर पळून गेले, ते देशाबाहेर गेले आहेत. दुसरा म्हणाला, ते पिंपळनगर मध्येच लपून राहिले आहेत. तिसऱ्याने वक्तव्य केले तर चौथा म्हणाला की त्यांनी चिंचेच्या झाडाला स्वतःला लटकवून फाशी घेतली आणि कचरेवाल्या मुलाला ते सकाळी सापडले असतील.
By noon, the small bank had gone through all its ready cash and the harassed manager was in a dilemma. Emergency funds could only be obtained from another bank some 30 miles distant and he wasn't sure he could persuade the crowd to wait until then. Dilemma, duvidha. Persuade, khatri patavne.
Dupar paryanta ti choti shi bank sagalya goshtitun geli hoti. आणि सतावलेला बँकेचा मॅनेजर द्विधा मनस्थितीत होता. 30 मैल दूर असलेल्या बँकेकडून आपत्कालीन निधी मिळवता येऊ शकत होता, पण तोपर्यंत ही लोकांचे मन वळवण्याची खात्री ते देऊ शकत नव्हते.
And there was no way of contacting Seth Govindram on his houseboat in Kashmir. People were turned back from the counters and told to return the following day. They did not like the sound of that.
आणि शेठ गोविंदराम यांना त्यांच्या काश्मीर येथील हाऊसबोटवर संपर्क करण्याचा कोणताही मार्ग दिसत नव्हता. लोकांना काउंटर्सवरून बाजूला करून दुसऱ्या दिवशी येण्यास सांगितलं गेलं. त्यांना हा त्यांचा सूर अजिबात आवडला नाही आणि म्हणून ते बँकेच्या बाहेर पायरीवर एकत्र उभे राहून आमचे पैसे परत द्या नाहीतर आम्ही तोडफोड करू.
And so they gathered outside on the steps of the bank, shouting, "Give us our money or we'll break in." And, "Fetch the Seth, we know he's hiding in a safe deposit locker." Mischief makers, who didn't have a paisa in the bank, joined the crowd and aggravated their mood. Aggravated, rag anla.
Ani Shedjina paratana. Amala maite, te surakshit jagi laplet. Asha prakare zorane urdat hote. उपद्रव करणारे लोक ज्यांचे या बँकेत काहीही पैसे नव्हते असे लोकही या जमावात सामील होऊन त्यांच्या रागामध्ये अजून भर घालत होते.
The manager stood at the door and tried to placate them. He declared that the bank had plenty of money but no immediate means of collecting it. He urged them to go home and come back the next day. Placate, समजूत घालणे, सांत्वन करणे.
बँकेचा मॅनेजर दरवाजाजवळ उभे राहून त्यांचा राग शांत करण्याचा प्रयत्न करत होता. त्यांनी जाहीर केले की बँकेमध्ये भरपूर पैसे आहेत आणि आता लगेचच पैसे गोळा करण्यासाठीचे माध्यम अस्तित्वात नाही. मॅनेजरने त्यांना घरी जाऊन दुसऱ्या दिवशी येण्याची विनंती केली.
वी वॉन्ट इट नाव, चॅन्टेड सम ऑफ द क्राऊड. नाव नाव नाव. And a brick hurtled through the air and crashed through the plate glass window of the People Nagar Bank. Nathu arrived next morning to sweep the steps of the bank. He saw the refuse and the broken glass and the stones cluttering the steps. Hurtled, vegane ali. Cluttering, kachra padlela.
Amhala attas paije ahet. Jamavane ekas dhosha lavla. Atta, atta, atta. आणि एक वीट हवेतून भिरभिरत आली व पिंपळनगर बँकेच्या खिडकीच्या काचेवर जाऊन आदळली. दुसऱ्या दिवशी नथू बँकेच्या पायऱ्या साफ करण्यासाठी आला. त्याने पायऱ्यांवर घाण आणि फुटलेल्या काचा तसाच दगडांचा कचरा पाहिला.
Raising his hands in a gesture of horror and disgust, he cried, "Hooligans, sons of donkeys, as though it isn't bad enough to be paid late, it seems my work has also to be increased." He smote the steps with his broom, scattering the refuse. Disgust, tiraskarane. Hooligans, murkha. Smote, marla.
काहीतरी भयानक झाले आहे असे समजून भीतीने आणि तिरस्काराच्या आविर्भावात हात उचलले आणि तो रडायला लागला. गुंड मवाली गाढव आहेत सगळे. माझा पगार उशिरा मिळत आहे हे कमी होते म्हणून की काय? त्यांनी माझे काम अजूनच वाढवून ठेवलंय. जोराने त्याच्या झाडूने पायऱ्यांवर आपटत पडलेला कचरा इतस्तः पसरवण्यास सुरुवात केली.
गुड मॉर्निंग नथू, सेड द वॉशरमॅन्स बॉय, getting down from his bicycle. Are you ready to take up a new job from the first of next month? You'll have to, I suppose, now that the bank is going out of business.
शुभ प्रभात नथु, धोब्याचा मुलगा सायकलवरून उतरून म्हणाला. पुढल्या महिन्याच्या 1 तारखेपासून तू नवीन नोकरी करण्यास तयार आहेस का? जर आता बँक कर्जबाजारी होत आहे तर बहुतेक तू तसं करशील असं वाटतंय.
How's that? said Nathu. Haven't you heard? Well, you'd better wait here until half the population of Pipalnagar arrives to claim their money. And he waved cheerfully. He did not have a bank account and sped away on his cycle.
ते कसं काय? नथूने विचारलं. तू ऐकलं नाहीस का? ठीक आहे, पिंपळनगरचे अर्धे अधिक लोक आपले पैसे घेऊन जायला येईपर्यंत तू इथेच थांब. आणि त्याचे बँकेत खाते नसल्याने आनंदाने हात हलवत सायकलवरून तो निघून गेला.
Nathu went back to sweeping the steps, muttering to himself. When he had finished his work, he sat down on the highest step to await the arrival of the manager. He was determined to get his pay. Muttering, Swatahashi putputne. Determined, nishchay karne.
Swatahashis kahitari putputat, Nathu punha bankecha payrya saaf karnyasathi gela. Jevha tyane tyache kaam sampavle, to bank manager yenyachi vaat pahat बँकेच्या सगळ्यात वरच्या पायरीवर बसला. आज त्याने त्याचा पगार घेऊन जायचे ठरवलेच होते.
Who would have thought the bank would collapse? He said to himself and looked thoughtfully into the distance. I wonder how it could have happened.
बँक कर्जबाजारी होईल असं कोणाला वाटलं होतं? आणि दूर कुठेतरी विचारांमध्ये स्वतःशीच पुटपुटला. आश्चर्य वाटतं, असं कसं झालं असेल?
Factual question. Name the characters of the story. Answer. The characters of the story are as follows. 1. Seth Govindram. 2. Nathu. 3. Sitaram. 4. Mrs. Srivastava. 5. Mrs. Bhushan. 6. Mr. Bhushan. 7. Kamal Kishore. 8. Deep Chand. 9. Elderly Gentleman. 10. Old Ganpat. 11. Bank Manager. 12. The people of Pipalnagar.
Which actions of Nathu shows his annoyance? Answer. Nathu was a sweeper boy at the Pipalnagar bank. He was angry because his request for his salary being increased by 2 rupees a month wasn't fulfilled. He also had not been paid his regular salary even though the month was almost over. Nathu expressed his annoyance by grumbling to himself. He was sweeping carelessly, which made dust fly over and land back where it was. He even banged the pan against the dustbin more time and loudly than necessary to show his anger and stress on his demand. By doing this, he was also trying to be confident and convince himself.
How do you show your annoyance? Answer. I try not to get annoyed with situations or people. But when I do, I try to calm myself down instead of lashing out at other people. I try to keep my distance and stay quiet so that I don't vent out my anger on them. I make an effort to think about the situation from another perspective to see if my annoyance is justified. When I find that it isn't, I calm down. And when I find that my annoyance is justified, I try to think of a way to express it without losing my temper. I understand that getting upset with the situation or with other people is not going to solve the problem. And that's how I usually express my annoyance. To whom did Sitaram talk about Nathu? Answer: Nathu wanted to leave his job as sweeper at the bank as he wasn't being paid properly. He spoke about his problem to Sitaram, who was the washerman's son. After hearing his friend, Sitaram agreed to help Nathu out by finding him another job. When he was on his daily routine, he heard a lady say that she needed a sweeper. Seeing a job opportunity available for his friend, Sitaram told the lady, Mrs. Srivastava, about Nathu. Why was Mrs. Bhushan uncomfortable? Answer: Mrs. Bhushan didn't bear the summer heat. She was fanning herself with a handkerchief. She affirmed that it was definitely the hottest in the history of People Nagar. Which shop was just next to the photography shop? Answer: The barber shop was just next to the photography shop. Who did Deep Chand call a bird? Answer: Deep Chand called Seth Govindram a bird. Who was Mrs. Srivastava talking to? Answer: Mrs. Srivastava was talking to Mrs. Bhushan. Who surprised everyone and how? Answer: As the false news about the bank spread quickly across the market, it even reached the old beggar on the street. Old Ganpat had a bent leg, which is why he sat in the corner and begged all day. In the evening, someone would come with a cart to carry him home. Nobody knew he could walk as he had never been seen walking. But when he heard the bank was about to collapse, he jumped to his feet and started running towards the bank as fast as he could. This action and the fact that he had 1,000 rupees saved in the bank astonished everyone. What were the four rumors about Seth Govindram? Answer: People were absolutely certain that Seth Govindram had fled as he was aware of the collapse of People Nagar Bank. Some were saying he had fled the state. Others were saying he had fled the country. He was hiding in People Nagar, said a third. He had hanged himself from a tamarind tree, said a fourth. This way, there was confusion among the people of People Nagar about the existence of Seth Govindram, where he was and what the actual situation was. Who was the last to know about the People Nagar Bank going bankrupt? Answer: Nathu was the last to know about the People Nagar Bank going bankrupt. Discuss and share. How are rumors spread? Are the rumors harmful? Why? Why not? Answer: Rumors are spread and fatally leave people misinformed. People with mean mentality take benefit of rumors to cheat people. Rumors are harmful because it leads to loss of people.
English workshop. 1. Who am I? Identify the character from the extract. A. I am the washerman's son. Who am I? Answer: Sitaram. B. I am the owner of the bank. Who am I? Answer: Seth Govindram. C. I am the sweeper. Who am I? Answer: Nathu. D. I am the friend of Mrs. Srivastava. Who am I? Answer: Mrs. Bhushan. E. I am the hairdresser. Who am I? Answer: Deep Chand. F. I have a crooked leg. Who am I? Answer: The beggar Ganpat.
2. Make a list of customers of People Nagar Bank from the extract. Answer: A. Deep Chand. B. An elderly gentleman. C. General merchants. D. The beetle seller. E. The tailor.
and many others are the list of customers of People Nagar Bank. 3. Match the following and write the complete meaningful sentences. Answer: Column A, Column B. 1. Sitaram was looking out for any job that might suit Nathu. According to Mrs. Bhushan, it was the hottest summer in the history of People Nagar. Govindram was holidaying in Kashmir. The manager told the customers to go home and come back the next day. 4. Write who said to whom. 1. Don't raise such dust. Answer: Sitaram said to Nathu. 2. Who would have thought the bank would collapse? Answer: Nathu said to himself. 3. Where did you disappear? Answer: Mrs. Bhushan said to Mr. Bhushan. 4. The bird has flown. Answer: An elderly gentleman said to Deep Chand. 5. Why was the manager of the bank in a dilemma? Answer: The harassed bank manager was in a dilemma because people of the town were demanding their money as they heard the rumor of bankruptcy. Emergency funds could be obtained from another bank at some 30 miles distance, and he wasn't sure he could persuade the crowd to wait until then. And there was no way of contacting Seth Govindram on his houseboat in Kashmir. 6. Cross the odd man out. 1. Sweeper, hooligan, beggar, declare, manager. Answer: The odd man out is declare. 2. Hurriedly, carelessly, salary, definitely, suddenly. Answer: Salary. 3. Imminent, latest, pavement, awful, shocking. Answer: Pavement. 4. Morning, scattering, raising, collecting, shouting. Answer: Morning. 7. Find the describing words for the following from the text. 1. Tour. 2. Shop. 3. Window. 4. Leg. Answer: The describing words are 1. Customary tour. 2. Photographic shop. 3. Glass window. 4. Crooked leg. 8. Complete the following table. Verb, noun, adjective, adverb. Pay, payment, payable, payable. Suddenness, sudden, suddenly. Declare, declaration, declarative, declaratively. Cheer, cheer, cheerful, cheerfully. Nine. Write in your own words a few sentences about each of the following. A. Nathu. Answer: Nathu was a sweeper boy. He worked for the People Nagar Bank. He wasn't paid regularly. The news of his non-payment was spread in the town and became a rumor. He was rather disgruntled about this and was looking for another job. His mind and heart were not in his work due to irregular payments, and therefore he did not do his work properly. The story ends with Nathu's remarks. B. Mrs. Srivastava. Answer: Mrs. Srivastava needed a sweeper. She was told that the sweeper boy at the bank was leaving his job due to irregular payment. This news by Mrs. Srivastava and Mrs. Bhushan, her friend, was spread, and within minutes, a rumor of bankruptcy spread into People Nagar. C. Seth Govindram. The bank in People Nagar was owned by Seth Govindram. When the rumor of bankruptcy spread in the town, he was out of station. People sought his whereabouts. They knew that Seth Govindram was holidaying in Kashmir. Meanwhile, the people in the town said that Seth Govindram had fled or absconded or died. They did not bother to find out the truth behind the matter. D. Sitaram. Sitaram was the washerman's son. He was a hard-working guy. He came to know that Nathu, the sweeper boy, did not get regular payment. Sitaram assured him that he would find another suitable job for Nathu. So he mentioned this to Mrs. Srivastava, who was in search of a sweeper. He even told her why Nathu was seeking a change in job quite unknowingly. Therefore, Sitaram was the first person who was responsible for spreading the rumor of bankruptcy. 10. Expand the theme in a write-up of about 20 lines. A. Rumors are spread by fools and accepted by greater fools. Rumors are spread by fools and accepted by greater fools. This happens as nobody cares for the surety or validity of the news they have heard from others. Always consider the source of an information when you hear or read about it. There are always plenty of fools to spread gossip and rumors, and some foolish people accept what they say without ever questioning them or attempting to discover the truth. Today, the internet plays a vital role behind rumors. By using the internet, some people can spread rumors without even leaving their home. They simply type some lies and allow other fools to spread the rubbish. The people behind the rumors are malicious cowards, and people don't stop to question their credibility or their hidden agenda. You should refuse to be played by these fools. Never accept a rumor blindly. There was a report that stated around 70% of the information you hear is proved false. Be wise and always be skeptical of rumors passed along by fools to other fools. You should be firm only about the concrete information that you receive. B. Books are our real friends. Books are our real friends. They play an important role of a guide in our life. When we want any know-how, we can go to our books and find what we wish to know. So, they are real companions. All the knowledge on this planet and beyond our reach is there in the books. They are treasures of knowledge. We read from them. We get fun and enjoyment from them. They boost our confidence and courage to speak. Books help us to improve language skills such as reading, listening, speaking, writing, and communication. Books develop our personality. Passion of reading keeps us away from bad habit and company. They help us to focus on our tasks. I like to read books and get knowledge as they are treasures of knowledge. 11. Project. Collect the names of books written by Ruskin Bond. Answer. The books by Ruskin Bond are 1. The Room on the Roof, 2. The Blue Umbrella, 3. The Flight of Pigeons, 4. Delhi is Not Far, 5. Cherry Tree, 6. Angry River, 7. A Season of Ghosts, 8. The Adventures of Rusty, 9. Lando Days, 10. The Hidden Pool. Language study. 1. I know of a sweeper boy who's looking for work. Observe the underlined part of the sentence. It tells us more about the sweeper boy. An adjective clause begins with words such as how, that, what, whatever, who, which, where, why, etc. Now, complete the sentences given below using your own adjective clauses. Answer. 1. I know of a schoolboy who stays in a hostel. 2. I know a joke that is very funny. 3. I know a doctor who is well known for his treatment. 4. I know of a place where you will find peace of mind. 5. I know the reason why the trains are late. 2. Rewrite the following sentences, joining them with when, where, which, why. 1. Sitaram had a bundle of freshly pressed clothes. He balanced it on his head. Answer: Sitaram had a bundle of freshly pressed clothes which he balanced on his head. 2. A large shady tamarind tree grew at one end of the bazaar. Mrs. Srivastava found her friend Mrs. Bhushan there. Answer: A large shady tamarind tree grew at one end of the bazaar where Mrs. Srivastava found her friend Mrs. Bhushan. 3. The People Nagar Bank stopped paying its employees when it was about to collapse. The People Nagar Bank stopped paying its employees when it was about to collapse. 4. He had finished his work. He sat down on the biggest step. When he had finished his work, he sat down on the biggest step. 5. Mrudula spoke to the police. He was on his duty. Mrudula spoke to the police who was on his duty. Tenses. Tense is the form of a verb which shows the time at which an action takes place. The past, she went. The present, she goes. The future, she will go. There are 4 verb forms. Main form, ing form, past passive form. They show both tense, past, present, future, and aspect, perfect, progressive. The progressive continuous aspect is formed by using be plus verb ing. They are or they were going. The perfect aspect is formed by using have plus verb ed en. They have or had gone. The present tense. 1. Simple present. I go home. She goes home. 2. Present progressive. I am going. They are going. 3. Present perfect. He has gone. They have gone. The past tense. 1. Simple past. She went. They went. 2. Past progressive. I was going. We were going. 3. Past perfect. We had gone. He had gone. 4. Past perfect progressive. I had been going. They had been going. The future tense. 1. Simple future. I will go. You will go. 2. Future progressive. We will be going. She will be going. 3. Future perfect. He will have gone. 4. Future perfect progressive. I will have been going. They will have been going. Subject verb agreement. The appropriate form of the verb is to be used according to the subject. In the simple present tense, S or ES will be added to the verb only when the subject is he, she, it. Read the following. I, we, you, they want a pen. He, she wants a pen. He, she goes home in time. Similarly, the form of the auxiliary verb will have to be used according to the subject in present progressive, past progressive, present perfect, etc. Read the following. I am writing an essay. We are writing an essay. He, she is writing an essay. I have written an essay. He, she has written an essay. I was writing an essay. We were writing an essay.